Hi, Tim Crown. What's up? How are you guys doing? Well, what do we have today in the news? Oh, I can't wait. Welcome to my channel, guys. I'm done watching the movie Lionheart. And here is my verdict. Okay, I'm a critic, so I will try to take it easy, okay? But you know, when you expect too much in a movie, that's what it turns out to be. So it's really not my fault, okay? Now let us start from the good part. The video was shot in Enugu, and also the cars that were used in the movie, Jeeps, okay, it's some Nigerian made cars. So I give it to Genevieve on that, encouraging Nigerian stuff, and that shows the beauty of Nigeria. The pictures amazing, directing amazing. I'm kind of impressed with all of these things. Okay, now storyline. I don't know. Before we get into that, okay? Before we get into that, I talked about Enugu. It was shot in Enugu. That's cool. Woman power. Okay, it shows us what women can do. Genevieve and Osofia, they're related. Osofia is Genevieve's uncle, so he was the one who came over, or who Peter Duche sent for to help Genevieve run the company. So because Genevieve was down, she was feeling down because when Osofia came, she felt Osofia is coming over to take over the company from her, that her father did not believe in her because she's a female and blah blah blah. That if Obiora, which was Fino, was interested, in taking over or being part of the company, the dad wouldn't have invited Osofia. So it's more like a woman showing us what a woman can do. Good.
His reasons have nothing to do with you being a woman. Your uncle is just here to supervise.
Now let's talk about the actors, okay? Osofia did great. Amazing actor. Of course, he's a veteran actor, so you always enjoy his part. I don't know. I just love Osofia's part. Now, Peter Duche is a legend, of course, no doubt about that. Now, Kanayo is Pascal Igwe, okay? The character he played was Pascal Igwe. He's like a competitor, I think. He also have his own company.
Chief.
Daddy,
Chief.
Daddy, what's wrong?
My deepest condolences. Sorry, my best wishes.
About the storyline, the Lionheart company owed almost ₦1 billion. Okay, they got a loan and couldn't pay back, so they have few days, like 30 days, to pay back.
Lionheart is in severe debt.
₦950 million.
What?
The acting was amazing. Everybody, did their best. They were on their A game. Okay, they did their best. Genevieve, of course, she's been in the industry for some time now, so she pulled it off. She pulled it off. And Jemima Osunde, they were all there. This guy Kalu, I want to give special recognition to this guy, Kalu Ikeagu, which was the snake who was working in the company. So that's basically it. Not a comprehensive one. I would just urge you guys to go watch. Now, is the movie overrated? Is it overhyped? I think yes. Now here's the thing. I check out someone's comment. Okay, I was going through the comment section and I stumbled on this comment, and this person's just said it all. Abiodun Schweib said, concerning Lionheart, it was a beautiful picture, nice production, and professionally directed. Aside from that, I was not impressed at the storyline. The storyline was a very weak one. No anxious moments, no suspense. I'm student of Florida Institute of Art studying movie production and sound engineering. He just spoke my mind. That is exactly what was running in my head. Okay, I think it's overhyped. I was expecting more from the storyline, but I get what this lady Genevieve was trying to do. It's a nice movie, don't get me wrong, but when something is exceptional, I'm talking about the storyline. Good pictures, great pictures, okay? Nice film generally, but is it spectacular? I wouldn't say yes, but it's a good movie. What happened in that movie, you could see it in hundreds and thousands of movies. Okay, the suspense is not that strong. I don't know how I'm gonna put it, but anyways, if you watch it, you're still going to be satisfied. That is just the thing. Okay, you're still gonna be satisfied, but I think it's overhyped. That's what I think. So on the scale of 1 to 10, like, I'll just give you 7. Okay, 7. Genevieve tried. Okay, so that is my verdict. What is yours? Have you seen the movie? You know, I'm a critic, all right? So don't hold me for that. I'm just being real, okay? But if you ask me, oh, is the movie nice? It's a nice movie, trust me. Okay, that is it. Guys, let me know what you think about the movie in the comment section if you've watched the movie. Now let's talk about the Sound City Award. If you're always on Instagram, you would have stumbled on this, you know. Sound City just organized their award ceremony. I think they tried in this year's award ceremony. That being said, it was on Saturday, 5th of January, 2019. Burna Boy stole the show. He wasn't around. The mom was there to help him out.
Tonight, thank you, Sound City. Burna is out of the country. He asked me to personally be here. I should be asleep by now, but I'm glad I came. Thank you, the fans who have hung around through thick and thin. Thank you for 2018. 2019, expect more madness.
I'm a fan of Burna Boy, okay? This guy, even before he started receiving an award, I was like, this guy would one day receive an award. Most of you that have been following me would agree with me on that. So Burna Boy won, like, I think 4 hours or 3 hours. I'm not that sure, but let me just quickly read out the list. I'm going to skip those ones that are not that necessary. Best Male MVP, Burna Boy. On that list, they have Nasty C, Mr. Easy, Olamide, aka Shadawali, Harmonize, Diamond Platnumz, Davido, Wizkid. They have Best Hip Hop. Best Hip Hop, am I still on the list? Calligraph, Nasty C, aka is the winner, all right? Kwesi Ator on the same list, Fino, Sakodie, Questa, Fowls, Medical. Okay, Best Pop. Now, where's Kiss Daniel, bro? Like, where's Kiss Daniel? Do you think this guy won an award this year or last year? Even on the top 10, I think MTV's top 10 or top 20 songs. Top 10 songs or top 10 artists. But MTV released a list then, and Kiss Daniel didn't make the list. But Best Pop, Davido won. Oh, gosh. Best Collaboration, Soko, Starboy feature. And this Soko, you know, really, I would say help someone like Terry, who is working so hard on that label, Starboy. So Soko is doing well, and yeah, I wasn't even expecting, even when I listened to this song at first, I never knew this song is gonna receive this much attention or award.
When I come through, they know we survive, so they turn up all eyes on me now. So many things we fit to do with your magical baby.
Now here we have the Digital Artist of the Year, Mr. Easy. Now Video of the Year goes to Patrick Rankin, Heal the World. Nice one by Patrick Rankin. Now Song of the Year, yay, we have Burna Boy here again. Burna Boy, Song of the Year. Soko on the same list. Amaka by Two Face on the same list. Assurance by Davido on the same list. And Burna Boy walked away with that. Okay, Best New Artist. Here's where I have a problem with Peruzzi. But before I come to that, let me just quickly, you know, go through this. Teni Ola. Now, Kirakuz. A lot of people don't know Kirakuz. There was a pick competition there and he won the pick competition. I could still remember the day he won it, and I've been following this guy ever since. He's now in the UK, but comes and goes. He has a new song out now again. Yeah, I'm jumping to the song now, right now, of course.
Party don't start again. DJ bring it back again. Put it on the beat again. Give me to my shot again. Cisco when I unleash the dragon. Disco when I step on the dance floor. I don't wanna talk too much.
Okay, we have Odunsi. Yeah, Peruzzi on the same list. Odunsi as well is doing well. viewer's choice summing so Wandeko, yeah, Wandeko what did. Now listener's choice, yeah, again, listener's choice, Burna Boy winner. Now, African artist of the year, Burna Boy. The same list we have Davido, we have Wizkid, we have Nasty C, we have Olamide, and Burna Boy walked away with that. Sako Die, Yemi Alade. Wow. Well, DJ of the year, we have DJ Neptune winner. Ah, well, that is pretty much it, guys. Okay, the wedding introduction of Mo Abudu's daughter, Temi Dayo. Even though everybody was saying that the mom stole the show, Mo Abudu, the media mogul, she stole the show. Why I'm congratulating her, but there's something I noticed. The girl looks like she's pregnant, looks like she's covering something. Okay, look at all the pictures she took. Her hand was covering a tummy. Okay, somehow she's covering something. Check out all the pictures. Look at this one as well. She used a hand fan to cover that. It might not be intentional, but I don't know. Why do you have to cover that, you know, in all your pictures? Now, check out this one as well. Every picture, she was just covering something. Looks like she is pregnant. I think so. She's trying to keep that away from the media, I think. Well, that is it, guys. I just want to point that out. We have Linda Osifo. She has been breaking the internet recently, even 2019. Well, that's our picture of the day. Yeah, shout out to Linda Osifo. Let's talk about Peruzzi. Now, Peruzzi reacting to the award. He said, personally, I did say I worked hardest last year. Peruzzi, are you sure? I'm, you know, a fan of Peruzzi, okay? Because of his struggles, looking back to how he started and to what he has become today, being part of the DMW. You know, kudos to Peruzzi. Shows that this guy is working hard. But hardest last year, it's okay, you know, to praise yourself. I think Tenny did well, because look at all your songs, your own songs. The songs that you could say gave you more attention are the songs someone featured you. They are not originally your songs. Okay, let me just put it that way. Having said that, collabo, but they don't say collabo follow for promo, according to Timaya. Yes, it follow for promo. That is why you got the attention. But your personal songs, I'm not convinced enough. Yeah, he released, which got pretty much buzz, but even on YouTube, it's not even up to 1 million views, okay? But he tried, okay? Now, is this guy talented? Very, very talented. Did he work hard? He worked hard, obviously. But Tenny, who won the award between himself and Tenny? Tenny won the award. All our songs are hit songs. Shout out to Peruzzi, but do not compare yourself with Tenny. Like, it's just a huge difference. But what even made you, you know, got the attention last year? Let us look at this closely. Amaka, yes, and the features with DMW, okay, got millions of views on YouTube. So is he a great artist? Yes, I think Peruzzi is a great artist. I think he put out an album late last year, or an EP, I think, Hard Work. Yeah, so that is it, guys. Let me know what you think about this. Let me know that in the comment section below. We've changed this whole thing. I told you I'm going to be doing more videos this year, okay? But January might be slow. Okay, it might be a little bit slow, but I'll be doing more videos this year. This is the end of the video. Okay, it's just one video. Thank you, guys. Until we see next time. Peace.